Hey everybody, this is Dave Kettlewell and...
Hi there, I'm Bill Wolf. I'm here at Dave's house and we're going to customize this new harp of mine.
He got a Swan SW1248M and we're going to talk a little bit about the customizations and have you come with us. Now, what I was saying to Bill was that every time parts touch, there's usually some air loss, or at least potential for air loss. And on this particular design, you know, which is a two-piece mouthpiece from Swan SW1248M, there's of course the fit of the mouthpiece to the comb, and there would also be the fit of the slide in the mouthpiece. And so every one of these junctures, the comb to the slide to the mouthpiece, are all sources of air loss. And so what we're going to do is we're going to first of all take apart his harmonica and strip it down to the comb, then we're going to flatten the comb by sanding, and then we're going to lap the mouthpiece into the top of the comb so it sits a little bit lower, and then we're going to lap this slide into the mouthpiece. When I take apart an instrument, I always have a plastic container like this, and then the parts go into this so that they're not lost.
I think I'm rushing you.
Well, first step is take off the covers. You wouldn't want to sand a comb with the reed plates still on it because you'll dirty them up. So we'll just inspect this while we're here, and we'll go ahead and take the take this off, and that's just a matter of putting a screw in this here and just unscrew this stuff. I also usually mark the top reed plate and the bottom just for fast identification. And again, we're just going to unscrew all these reed plate screws. This particular harmonica has a construction I kind of like where there's screws at the very front of the comb in addition to the ones in the back. It makes a more airtight instrument. Now what we've done is we've got the reed plates off like this. So we got two reed plates here, and then the next thing you want to do is you always want to remove the slide spring here, and because it'll pop out while you're sanding, and we're ready to get starting with our sand. Okay, the next thing we're going to do here is we're going to sand the top of the comb. And Swans are pretty flat from factory, but not perfectly flat. Let's say hi to Bill. You having fun?
Yes, I'm having fun. I'm learning a lot here.
Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead, and what I'm using is I'm going to start off with something like a, let's see here.
Here's a 320. Is this emery? Is that what?
It's just sandpaper.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you just take and lay the comb here, the front here, and just a glass table so it's flat.
Oh, yeah.
And then we just do like this, and we take a look at the comb, and we see, you know, how is it doing? And I can see it's still got some areas here that are high spots. You want to be careful when you do this that you keep on moving it, and you want to put your hand pressure even so you're not heavier here than here. When the sandpaper starts to get filled up with stuff, just set it aside and use another one. You don't really want to sand on a piece of paper that has a lot of gunk on it. Let's see how we're looking here. It's a little finer paper. As the sandpaper gets dirty, you wipe it off, so you don't want to be sanding on residue. I'm going to come in here and these are 300, 400, 500 grit papers. You don't want to take off too much too quick. You're better off just moving slow. And then it'll start looking real silky on the top as it starts looking really flat now.
Yeah.
Okay, and that it had a few imperfections. These Swans are pretty good, better than Hohner and Suzuki, which is amazing when you consider that the Swan's only a $100 instrument. Now, another thing to be aware of is, of course, you do have the brass inserts here in the comb for the screws, and sometimes they'll flop out, but normally they won't. I just keep an eye on that to make sure that they don't escape, and I'm going to do another visual check of this comb right now, and I'd say it's looking pretty good. Keep on going a little bit more, but if this was a Suzuki or Hunter, we'd do this for half an hour. So we're taking a look here. It's about as smooth as glass right now. It's in very, very nice shape. And once it's good, that's it. Now, our next procedure is to what's called lap, L-A-P-P, the mouthpiece here to lap the mouthpiece into the comb. And the part that touches the comb on these mouthpieces is just a very, very thin little teeny section here, that little ridge on the inside. It's a very small area, and it'll cut right into that. So we're really, that's what's going on, and you want to be careful never to bend a slide when you're working on them. So the method here is you just take a bunch of toothpaste, and I usually put it on here, and then you just kind of rub it like this, see? And we're just putting a thin layer of toothpaste on that edge that we're going to lap. And the nice part about toothpaste is it doesn't have a bad odor, and it's not, there's no chemicals in it that could be damaging or dangerous. And then we take the mouthpiece and we take a piece of paper towel. We set this over. And see, I'm just going to rub back and forth. That's called lapping. And you want to make sure that you're oriented properly on it. And then to... you can see they do, it flops around, it's wet and it's got toothpaste on it. What you do is you just take this paper towel that's a little damp, and I use that to hold this here. And I just take it. And the trick is to take the mouthpiece equally along the whole comb. And the mouthpiece itself, the metal mouthpiece, is not really changing, it's the plastic. And if you look at it, you'll see the plastic. You can see it's working, that channel. But it's not doing anything to the underside because this is metal. So it's not like you're damaging the mouthpiece in any way. You're only changing the shape of the comb. And since it's not really sanding the mouthpiece, it doesn't really matter where I hold on to the mouthpiece. So all I want to do is just work with this comb. We're going to go down about 1/10,000th of an inch. That's not very much. And when I feel it starting to dry out, like it's doing now, I'll put on more toothpaste. This mouthpiece is flat, but some of the Honers and Suzukis have curvature, and if that's the case, it's a little harder. But this one's totally flat. The Swans don't have any curvature this way. So you can just lay it on there flat and work it. So it's an easy instrument to work on. You can feel with your finger to nail. If you can feel it, it's at least at 1/10,000th. We're done on this. I'm going to clean. The next procedure that we're going to do is we're going to lap the slide into the mouthpiece. For that, we use a board like this. Then we take this, and we take this, which is the slide, and I attach it to another comb so that I can apply pressure down. Uh-huh. So now what I'm trying to do is increase the tolerance and tighten this up. Same deal. So I'm going to, but this will be this whole section up here. I'm going to try to with impact because that slide touches the whole thing. So again, the methodology is to take, set it in here correctly in its position, and just push that slide into that mouthpiece, work it in. Now, we're done with the lapping of the slide onto the mouthpiece, and now all the parts have to be carefully cleaned and then reassembled. You want to take your time and go real slow in the washing and make sure you get everything clean or you'll taste the toothpaste. If you have a sprayer, it goes a lot better. You can apply a lot more air water pressure. After I wash this real carefully with water, then I'm going to take a toothpaste and a toothbrush and actually scrub everything. But I can do a real good job just with the water, you can see, because I can apply this water heavy duty. Now we're going to use a toothbrush and detergent and scrub the parts. Now we're ready for our final rinse. Use pretty hot water, not scalding, because it's too hot for your hand, but the warmer it is, it does tend to clean better. Get your pressure up. Just do it longer than you think you should have to. And you're like, oh, that's good enough. Well, it's not. You just want to keep on cleaning. You got to get all the residue of that out or you will taste it when you play. Clean. Mouthpiece too. Take twice or three times the time that you think it should. They have to do the job. Increase the heat a little bit here. Really get in here. And then do this. Okay, now we're going to apply, we're going to dry stuff and then we're going to use slide oil and reassemble everything. First step in the rebuild is to put back on the reed plates. So I'll do that. Our first step is to reset the slide. That's always going to be best done with a pair of pliers. So I come in here and I know that it's going to be like this. So what we do is we take a hold of this, bend it in and under. That's it. You want to make sure it's seated correctly, and now our slide spring's in there and ready to go. And because the reed plates were marked top and bottom, it's very easy for me to put them in the right position. Now the screws go in. Just setting the screws in. Very straightforward part of the job. All the screws are now in position, and the way to properly put in a screw is that you turn left until you hear it click and then you take it in, and there's no chance of stripping the screws. Let me show you this again. So when you put in the screw, turn left until you hear the pop and then take it down, and don't take them tight, just put them in real gently. Left, pop, down. Left, pop, down. They're just hardly snug. Then I'm just going to take them down just a tiny bit. all of them and bring it down. I've found that it's helpful to steady the screwdriver on the thumb so you're not doing this. Okay, I'm ready for the final tighten up now, and I kind of usually do this by hand. Just come to here and just take them just a hair snug all the way around. They don't have to be real tight. You don't want to make them real tight because they'll damage the threads. You just want to get them very snug. It helps to have a professional screwdriver like this because it fits those little tines perfectly. And do the job correctly. And then come over here. And I usually walk through all the screws a second time just to make sure that everybody got tightened. Next thing to do is put the covers on so that you protect the unit as quickly as you can. Pick up the unit, line up the screws, put them in. I hold the lower one in place with my index finger and then place the other. If they don't align properly, drop your fingertip so that you can get them aligned properly. Don't strip these, they strip easy. For the final tightening on this, you want to make sure your numbers are on the top when you've got your thing here. You push those covers down with your fingertip, then you come in here for your final tighten. You got to be careful, it's only an ABS plastic comb, it's not metal, so you don't want to go too tight on this, just good and snug. That completes that portion. We're almost complete with our customization. Now we want to apply slide oil, but you wouldn't want to put oil between the slide and the comb. You only want metal to metal, so you put it on top surface and underside of this mouthpiece. That's it. When you do this, use a very small amount. You put a little bit on your fingertip. You rub it in. Don't forget, we only want the top and the sides. Right like that. And this little guy goes here. If you put oil on the plastic to metal, it'll just slow it up. It doesn't have any good properties at all.
Gum it.
Now we come again. I come a little heavier now. And I'm going to actually hit this underside of this mouthpiece. I want to screw it back together. When you go to put a harmonica back together again, your methodology, of course, is to butt your unit up against something like this as the edge of the sink. I have two screws I'm going to be putting in. And of course, these need to be set, so you stick them through. Then you put on your bumper and seat it deeply. They fall off. Sometimes you want to hold it sideways, not up and down. I'm going to set this bumper as well. Look for your channel cut in the underside, right here. Come here. This can be laid generally into position. Push the slide in so that it's free, and we're ready to begin our final action, which is to bring our mouthpiece screws down. And the way you do this to tighten it properly is you tighten them and just keep moving. Keep moving your slide with your thumb. Come over here. As long as it's still moving smoothly, I know there's no problems. So that completes this customization.
So what's the difference, Bill?
I don't know if I can explain it. It's overall easier to play. It seems like it's easier to blow on it.
So it responds a little faster to the breath.
Yeah, exactly.
Great. That's it. Take care.